Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. My name is Manikant. I am from Aeronautical A. Now I am going to say about Hooke's law. First of all, let us forget about Hooke's law. Let us discuss about other two topics which are important for us rather than Hooke's law. That is stress and strain. Stress. It's a resistance offered by a body to any deformation. Mathematically, it is expressed as the restoring force per unit area. So that is given as stress is equal to the force per unit area is known as stress. What about strain? So see this, for stress, it is a normal stress upon saying this is a normal stress which is acting perpendicular towards the area. And the shear stress acting parallel towards the surface. This is what the stress defines. And this time I said that what is a strain? Strain is a deformation per unit length in the direction of deformation. So deformation per unit length in the direction of deformation is known as strain. That is a change in length towards the original length is known as strain. So this is what strain. So upon stretching the hand which is tied by a rubber band, it undergoes deformation and it's undergoes a change in length to its towards its original length. So this is known as the strain due to the stress acting upon it. Observatively, we can say that just now upon seeing the animations, we can say that the stress is directly proportional towards strain. Yeah, right. Do you want to see it again? See, upon the human keeping a stress on the rubber bands, they are undergoing a strain proportionally. So that's application. The stress is directly proportional to the strain. So stress is equal to Young's modulus of elasticity into strain. Since Young's modulus of elasticity E is known as a proportionality constant. And this is given as sigma is equal to E times E, which stress is equal to strain times the Young's modulus of elasticity, where sigma is stress, E is the modulus of elasticity, and epsilon is the strain. And this is Hooke's law. The derivation of Hooke's law is this. It says that the stress is directly proportional to the strain, and thereafter it gives a proportionality constant as the modulus of elasticity. And this is what the Hooke's law that is stated. The strain in a solid is proportional to the applied stress within the elastic limit of the solid. That is, the stress is directly proportional to strain. The strain in a solid is proportional to the applied stress within the elastic limit. So within an elastic limit, the stress is directly proportional to the strain. Upon the elastic limit, on increasing a stress upon elastic limit, the strain is going to be permanent and it doesn't come into original length due to the excess of stress. So that is, the stress is directly proportional to strain. And E is a proportionality constant. Do you know the units of stress? That is Newton per meter square. And strain is a dimensionless number. So what will be the SI units of elasticity? That is modulus of elasticity. It has the same units as stress. That is Newton per meter square. So this is what the Hooke's law states. And applications of Hooke's law. Most commonly, in everyday life, Hooke's law is applied. It springs because of their elasticity. It is used as a fundamental principle behind manometers, spring scale, and balance wheel of the clock. Disadvantages of Hooke's law. Hooke's law is applied only in an elastic region. Hooke's law gives an accurate result only for solid bodies if the forces and deformations are small, and it is not universal law. Hooke's law is a not universal law, and it doesn't give a accurate result for the deformation which is large. Thank you so much.